Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to the next part of Austria. Let's play on the Common Sense expansion. We are getting our army ready. Because we eventually want to attack Venice. We know that France will join the war. So we should really try to get Castile on our side, which they are not for right now. That sucks a lot. We cannot attack Venice without Castile's help. Oh, but the Mamluks declared war on Venice. Yep, and they are at war with France. So if we attack, would France still help them? Yes, they would. So I think I cannot attack Venice. If I'm playing like a historical Austria, maybe a bit. You know, I want to get the 8 achievements. Also get unions over Hungary, maybe Bavaria, Bohemia. So I will not play historical, I want the achievements, Steam achievements. But I'm trying to form the HRE, eventually. Let's fabricate another claim on Bourgogne. Oh no, only on shallow one for now. Another boat. Also protect in Venice. We are still collecting trade here. And we now have one ducat. We have no casus belli against Bavaria to release the states that there are. We only have a imperial liberation casus belli on Brandenburg and conquest on Venice. Imperial ban. Yeah, Brandenburg will help you out. So then I have to fight Brandenburg as well. Which could be a good option, because they have a lot of territory that could be released. Yeah, if you have formed the HRE, it is getting easy and boring. But I want all the achievements, all the Steam achievements. So I have to play as Austria. And I also want to check out the new Imperial Authority things. So if we get rid of 6 provinces that are not controlled by an empire state, then we get even more imperial authority every month. So that is what we are aiming for. How long until the tech? 60% is a lot. And we get another imperial liberation against Bavaria because they, I think they annexed, yeah, Augsburg. So we should really, yeah, we will attack Bavaria. They have to release the little states. Also, they can release Ansbach and Salzburg. Augsburg, Salzburg, and Ansbach. That is where we go for. So I can ask them to give it back. They will not accept, of course. But they have now a modifier that is not so nice for them. Alright. Set the army on the front. And we will attack Bavaria. We are one tech ahead already, so that should help us a lot. You have a question. Does it pay off to take some land from Hungary? They have some extra coring costs on their lands, if I'm not wrong. I have a union over them, so I will integrate them at once at some point. But I first want three personal unions before I will do that. But do they still have the extra coring cost? I don't think so. No, they don't have it yet. Maybe they... No, they also did not go for the aristocratic ideas. So that's not more the case anymore, but I have a personal union over them. Get the morale up and we will attack München. No one would help us again. Distant war, attitude, debt, allied with Bavaria. Brandenburg is close, but they have war exhaustion. But I can take this on myself. 8,000, Nuremberg should also have 8,000. Yeah, and we are ahead on tech, so I think we will win this war. Let's get München. And Hungary help us out, because they have no choice. Attack in the farmlands, please. And you go to the fortress of Obenfalls. Nuremberg and Ravensburg are in the war as well. Yeah, we will catch them and we will crush them, I think. Yeah, thousands people die every month, so we even have a stack wipe. We are very, very strong. So there are three forts in this area. So let's take the forts down. And try to keep our manpower up. I will take this decision and I will reduce the inflation once more. If you stay above 3% inflation, you get some nasty events sometimes. Maybe we could go for a level 2 advisor. Yeah, I think I will go for this guy, so he will keep our inflation a bit more down. Alright, Hungary is attacking here. Nice. I think they will win that battle. Do we have a claim on Salzburg? No, but I will take Salzburg for myself, I think. It depends on how many aggressive expansion we get. And we have München already. Stack wipe the one single armies. and you go siege up those two provinces. So this is going to be a very easy war. I will ask for war reparations from those three cities. We have Ingolstadt now. We have to wait until we conquer the forts. But we can walk like this. Just move together. Hungary is helping out again in Ravensburg. Yep, she is dead down. And then we will take Nuremberg as well. So this is a quick war that will not cost any manpower. Almost no manpower. Take Nuremberg. With our best leader in the world. Almost, I think. You want to peace out already? I will not. Let's crush the other armies. Well, maybe we should wait till we get our morale back. Hungary, please go siege this province. Yep, they are moving towards Ravensburg now. Nice. So it's now just waiting until we take all the forts and then we can peace out. What happens here? Denmark lost of Pomerania. But Holstein is back. Hey, that's nice. Holstein is back in the Empire. Yep. Thank you, Pomerania. Okay, and we siege this down. Let's... No, I will wait. I will take this battle. No, you have to wait with the peace. Okay, we have this fortress now. So... Yeah, we should attack them. And you should go as well and then return. Alright, very nice. So where are they going? To Ingolstadt. Now, you can stack wipe them. You are surprised that I haven't connected my Burgundian provinces yet. Oh, you mean this. Well, Switzerland likes us, so I could get military access very easily. But yes, you are right, it's maybe better to get a connection at some point. But the more princes we have, the more imperial authority we get. So I prefer not to give away of to take over those provinces. But yes, there is a possibility that Switzerland becomes hostile and then we have a problem. Stack wipe the army. Okay. They are still voting for us. Yep. Okay, Ravensburg is now fully sieged, so we could piece them out. Let's see what we can get. We can take them in the Empire. But I will not do this. So if you hover over the aggressive expansion tab, it now says that we will get between 1 and 21 aggressive expansion. So 21 in the surrounding area, that's a lot for one province. But it's a free city, I think that's why they are getting upset about it. But I will take this and war apps, maybe some money for you. Okay, you can go out. Now let's wait that we can peace out Nuremberg. And there goes Nuremberg. If you take Nuremberg, we get even more. Oh yeah, they are also a free city. Annul your treaties, give me your war reparations and your money. And go out. So you go to Tyrol, you go to Vienna, and you go to right. So now we peace out with Bavaria. I want you to release Ansbach, Augsburg, and Salzburg. I want your war reparations. And your money. There's a lot of inflation, I think. No, we can take it. So, Bavaria is brought back to its starting region, except Oberpfalz. So we get more princes in the Empire now. Welcome back. We again have 53 princes and we gain a little bit more now. And we only have 5 provinces left that are not control of non-member states. And we should hunt for those. And 3 provinces are here. Because Burgundy has a personal union over Hainaut. Oh no, they don't have it anymore. So, oh yes, they do. They lead a personal union over Hainaut. So that should be the next target to get Hainaut back as a free country. And I think I will take some land here to fight off France even more. Yeah, you are allied with not the biggest nations. And Castile will help us now. Yeah, we will go for that war. So, Switzerland, we need your military access. Go to there, and you go to there. How many armies do they have? How many armies have Burgundy has? They have only 6,000. And Hesse's army is already here, so yeah, this should be an easy war. Very easy. Let's fabricate a claim on Bourgogne. And we can tack up. Alright, so this is a very nice building. I will take the tech and now let me look at the buildings tab. we can build a workshop, and this gives local production efficiency plus 50%. We have a gold province, so I think we will get a lot of more production there. Ah, but they changed the way how it works. We cannot build a workshop because the province produces gold, so that is not possible. That's a shame, otherwise we will make so much more income from gold. Nah, that's a pity. We don't have that good production. No, I will not build this building. Maybe some more barracks. Yeah, I will build a barracks here. And here. So we get even more manpower. Let's see what for decision we have. Pass the Hirito Comberendo Act. And of course I will take that one. So we go attack Burgundy anytime now. They are tech 6, we are tech 6 as well. They are already at war with some nations, so I think this should be an easy war. Wait for the 2nd of August and we attack. Alright, so we will fight Burgundia, I know. Holland and Milan. Milan will also join. Mm. But Castile and Trier will help us out on the other side. Yeah, let's declare this war. And of course Hungary helps as well. Hungary will take care of Milan, I think. Okay, move in. You move here and you go to there. Trier is in, Castile is in, Milan is in, Holland is in. So this is now how it looks like. Should be very easy. You go into Tyrol. So this could be a stack wipe. And to help this out, I will send some reinforcements. Yep, that is the stack wipe. So you go back to this province and you go siege down Bourgogne. Does Milan have some princes that could be released? No. Oh, you can't sleep, Emily. So you are back. Well, nice that you came back for me. Yeah, maybe you can sleep in 1 hour. That's maybe possible. What time is it in Romania? There is the Milanese army. Grasslands. Yeah, fight them. Tech 6, yeah, okay. You are waiting for a result, and that's the time I can get it. So you are waiting for something, and because you need to know what will be the result. You can sleep. Is that the thing? Oh, and Slovakia is also here. And you will be really happy or really sad. Yeah, it all depends on the outcome. Well, I hope it's good news for you. Why should I? Well, yeah, I will go to Milan. So we are closing on taking the capital. Our army is under attack, but not anymore. So where are our armies? We have one here, here and here. I think you go to Milan and you will go somewhere else. Yeah, you can get access, I don't care. Can we reach this? Yeah, we should kill the last Burgundian province. They only have three provinces left. Picardy. Picardy is not in the empire. But we could take Artois and then join it in the empire. And then release Picardy. Then Picardy is a prince in the empire. That's a possibility. But we might get too much expansion, so we will check. Did I pass the second reform? No, not yet. We are getting there. We now only have five more provinces that are not owned by one of us, of the Empire. And again, we are already out of manpower. Yep, I play it also a lot. But I don't stop playing. I will keep playing. We can get another idea. Or we could get a shipyard. No, I don't want a shipyard. Yeah, just get the ideas going. So this is new. This is the second Austrian idea. And we get fort maintenance minus 10%. And more garrison growth plus 15% in our forts. So that's a nice bonus. Yeah, Trackmania is not time demanding, but for me it is, because I play it in the Electronic Sports League. So I have to train maps. Alright, let's get help this battle out. Thank you, Castile, for joining my war. Okay, we'll win this war, I'm sure. Yeah, see you, Browsy. Okay, we won that battle. So that's it for this episode. We'll see you in the next one, where we continue the war with Burgundy. We will get Hainaut free from Burgundy, and we will take those provinces, I think. So we have a buffer against France. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.